Hi, I'm Manidha.
And I'm Alice. Welcome to our video on Metta.
So for me, another word for Metta is simply love. And we're not talking about love here in the sticky or sentimental sense, but really love as openness, warmth, sensitivity, friendliness, or even kindness. And it's without boundaries, and it's without any separation whatsoever. Recently, I've been really interested in exploring what the different traditions and faiths have to say about love. And it seems like love is a common thread. It's a universal experience. Maybe it's what it simply means to be human.
The vision for this video was to share love poems from the perspective of people from all around the world, from different eras and different traditions, from a Sufi poet to a Catholic monk.
And the book that we're going to use for this video is titled Love Poems from God. And now I know as Buddhists, some of you may have a reaction to the word God, but we're not talking about God here in the theistic or sense or as God as an entity. So if it makes you feel more comfortable, Alice's prepared this handy dandy label with the word reality. And we can stick that on the cover. Because for me, God, in the sense that these poets are talking about, they're talking about reality.
We've selected five poems that correspond to the five stages of the Metta Bhavana.
Sometimes we can be really hard on ourselves or push our limits too far, when what we really need is self-metta. We can just stop, relax, open, and rest.
For the first stage, metta towards ourselves, we've chosen a poem by Hafiz titled Just Sit There Right Now.
Just sit there right now. Don't do a thing, just rest. For your separation from God is the hardest work in this world. Let me bring you trays of food and something that you like to drink. You can use my soft words as a cushion for your head.
Even people nearest and dearest to us can irritate us from time to time. However, this can be the best time to cultivate an intention to love.
For the second stage, metta towards a friend or loved one, we've chosen a poem by Rumi titled Relationship Booster.
Here's a relationship booster that is guaranteed to work. Every time your spouse or lover says something stupid, make your eyes light up as if you just heard something brilliant.
Isn't it amazing how two strangers can make a difference in each other's lives, even for just a moment? The next time you find yourself on the street, look directly into the eyes of a stranger and smile with a brilliance that can light up a sky. See what happens.
For the third stage, metta towards a neutral person, we've selected a poem by Meister Eckhart titled Love Does That.
All day long, a little girl labors, sometimes with heavy loads on her back, and sometimes just with worries about things that bother only burros. And worries, as we know, can be more exhausting than physical labor. Once in a while, a kind monk comes to her stable and brings a pear, but more than that, he looks into the burro's eyes and touches her ears. And for a few seconds, the burro is free and even seems to laugh because love does that. Love frees.
Metta as an insight practice helps us to break down the barrier between self and other. When we react to a difficult person, we create distance between ourselves and that person, and that separation can be quite painful. Separation is suffering.
For the fourth stage, metta towards a difficult person, we have selected a poem by St. Thomas Aquinas titled Otherwise the Darkness.
I have a cause. We need those, don't we? Otherwise, the darkness and the cold gets in and everything starts to ache. My soul has a purpose. It is to love. If I do not fulfill my heart's vocation, I suffer.
Metta is our spontaneous response that flows from our true nature. From this place, we transcend race, gender, religion. We do not calculate odds or keep score. Like the sun, the light of our love shines equally on the whole world and all beings.
For the fifth and final stage, Metta for All Beings, we have selected a poem by Hafiz titled, "The Sun Never Says."
Even after all this time, the sun never says to the earth, "You owe me." Look what happens with a love like that. It lights the whole world. May all beings be well.
May all beings be happy.
May all beings be free from suffering.
Thank you. Hi, I'm Alice.
And I'm Manidha. Hello, my name's Manidha.
And I'm Alice.
And this is Honey Lavender.
Here she is.
All right. So for me, metta, another word for metta is love.